And I am a fashionista in Paparazzi Accessories. And hello, everybody jumping in. Hey, guys. And I am here today. And today's topic, I'm going to talk to you guys about crushing your life of the party and selling goals. All right. As you all know, we are nearing close to the end of our paparazzi year. Okay. We only have until June 30th to crush these goals. So as you guys know, we are currently in the month of April, okay? So I'm not sure when you guys may watch this on the replay, but as of today, we are at the end of April, which means we only have May and June to crush these goals, okay? So what I want everybody to do is get a piece of paper, a pen. Let's get ready to take some notes. I have some information that's going to help you guys to learn selling tips, what you should do when it comes to your life of the party, you know, how to make sure you're on track. Always, and this is like the first kind of like tip, we'll get into the rest, but you know, the first tip is with any goal, try to always go above the goal. That way, you, if you fall a little bit short or if anything happens with your orders or anything like that, you're still good to go. So again, first, let's jump right into selling. Here are a couple of my tips, okay? So first thing I want to share with you guys is when I'm glad you guys are getting a square to go. Awesome. All right, so here we go. Let's get ready for today's training. All right, so again, when it comes to selling big and these life of the party goals, the first thing I want everyone to keep in mind is when you are selling, you want to make sure that you're not just selling one particular way and you are kind of like not even thinking about the other ways that you can sell your jewelry. And what do I mean by that? I mean, basically, everybody pretty much knows the fastest and quickest and most efficient way most of the time is to sell your jewelry on Facebook Live. Well, that is an awesome way. And I think to stick with going live, you want to always still stick with your schedules with your going live. But I want to want you guys to consider, and if you're taking notes, I want you guys to kind of follow me with what I'm going to do, right? So I have my little paparazzi pad here. So we're going to draw a circle on the pad, okay? So it's almost like our own little chart, okay? So we're going to break this into fours. And in one of the boxes, of course, we want to say we want to go live. And of course, my screen is going to be kind of backwards. So, you know, kind of forgive me with the writing. But this is going to be live, okay? But what I want everybody to consider is filling these other boxes of your chart with other ways that you can work your business and sell big, okay? So if you have a pen and paper, I'm going to give you guys a couple of suggestions of things that you can do. Because again, as you all know, the more jewelry that you can sell, the more that you can reinvest. And when it comes to life of the party goals, whatever goal that you are able to achieve by June 30th, you're going to carry that goal with you or that particular achievement with you for the whole year after, okay? So this is your hustle season, okay? So if you are a bling boss, this is your time to jump in and say, look, I'm in it to win it. I got to stay focused. I got to grind. I got to hustle. And I got to make sure I achieve whatever goal that I have set for myself. Because again, you're going to carry it with you all the way into 2022, okay? So what I want to suggest to everybody is to take some time to learn about all the levels of life of the party, whether it be bronze, silver, gold, or maybe even if you're trying to decide, should I go for gold or should I go for platinum? Should I go for diamond? Should I go for black diamond? You know the levels, know the perks at each level. So for instance, if you're trying to go for gold, you know that at gold, you're going to start getting double hostess rewards on everything. So let's say if you're kind of around the silver mark now and you're looking at gold and you're saying, wait, should I really hustle to gold? Because the perks at gold could help my business for the whole following year. And it's all about having a business mind, because again, each perk at each level is going to help your business in another way that, you know, another goal might not. Okay. So again, let's get into some suggestions and ideas of ways that we can sell. Okay. So the first suggestion or tip that I'm going to give you guys is do not forget about how this business started without Facebook Live. So again, when paparazzi first began, there was no such thing as Facebook Live, guys. Okay, so what were these ladies doing? I want you guys to share below. What do you think these ladies were doing at the beginning? How they were hustling in their business, how they were getting this jewelry out. What is the most popular, funnest thing that we can do in our business? Okay, share below, and I'm going to get ready to tell you guys. Okay, so this first way that we're going to talk about is, again, what our business is built on. It's kind of like that I can see you, you can see me, you can check out this jewelry, and I can meet new customers through doing this, okay? Every time you do it, this is just like I'm giving you guys some hints, like, are you getting closer? You know, Every time you do it, you can get around new people you've never seen before. You can play games. You can get dolled up. You can have a good time. You can give away hostess rewards. It's kind of like, you know. But the answer, guys, and someone said it first, Victoria, great job. Home parties, okay? So again, even if you're not in someone's home, I know with the pandemic and everything, you know, people are not doing like those in, you know, face-to-face home kind of parties, but you can still do virtual parties, guys. You still can. The same way I'm talking to you guys right now is how you can host parties with hostesses. So what I want to encourage everybody to do is try to stay booked with parties. Every weekend, if you can, try to get a party on the book, or two or three if you can. Stay booked and busy with parties, because again, if you can get a hostess and you can do like a virtual party, this is going to be a great way for you to be able to not only meet your hostess, but all of their friends and family that they have invited to this party. You can do the parties on Facebook, you can do them on Zoom, whichever way you choose to do it, still just get out there. And this is again a way for you to meet tons of people that you wouldn't ordinarily meet. While you're playing these games, try to book more parties. While you're doing these parties, try to book more parties from the parties, okay? Play games, you know, maybe give them incentives for booking a party with you that day. So again, the more parties you can book, the more people you can meet, and the more jewelry that you can sell, okay? So with parties, another way that we have for free with our access, you know, every month we have access to a free website, okay? So again, first thing was parties. The second thing are going to be our free website. And I know that the website's there. Sometimes people use it, sometimes they don't. But again, the website is there, guys, because you can go and get your 45% commission on everything that you sell. And not only that, but on the website, you're going to get PV. So every time someone buys something from your website, you're going to be able to get that volume. Why is that important? Because if you do have Life of the Party goals, your Life of the Party goals are going to be contingent on what you sell, as in your personal orders, and also what is sold on your website. Okay, so maybe what you can do is to set a plan, a strong game plan, to say, you know what, between now and the end of the paparazzi year, I can commit to selling and buying, you know, that kind of thing, this many pieces. But I'm going to also default to my website and try to push some website sales out. Because again, you might not be able to afford to, you know, pay for jewelry or get certain things certain times of the year. But again, if you can not only buy your jewelry, but also get those website sales coming in, then you'll be good to go. You know, so what I want everybody to do is to look at your Life of the Party goal. Take the total of the goal that you want to reach. So let's say I want to be bronze, I want to be gold, I want to be double platinum, you know, whatever. Take your goal, and from today, so you have two more months to go to get to your goal, you're going to take what your current volume is, and you're going to look at your total that you're trying to go for. So if you're trying to go for diamond, you're going to take the total for diamond and what your total is right now, and you're going to basically subtract the difference between where you are right now and where you're trying to get to, okay? That is the total volume that you're going to need before to get to whatever whatever your goal is. What I suggested at the beginning is to always bump it up a little bit. So let's say you look at it and you say, okay, I have to get 1,000 more pieces. Maybe bump it up to 1,050 pieces, you know, just so that you have some cushion in there. That way, if anything goes wrong, you know for a fact that you still have this in the bag, okay? So you take 1,050 pieces and then you divide that in two. And that is what you're going to have to do for the next 2 months, okay? So for the first month, I know I have to get this many pieces. The second month, I know I'm going to have to get that many pieces. Now, what you can do again is you can strategize on a weekly basis or on a daily basis. I know sometimes people will say, I know how many pieces of jewelry I have to get every day. So let's say when new releases comes out, you say, okay, I have to get at least 57 pieces a day. But you may say, all right, 57, I have to get 65, you know, just to be on the safe side. But let's say that day you only get 40 pieces. That now rolls over to your following day. You have to make sure you account for those pieces to make sure you're on track for the end of the week. Does that make sense? You guys give me some love and some hearts if you're with me so far, and it's all kind of making sense in what you need to do to make sure you're on track and you can crush these goals, okay? Don't forget below, you could tag your teams in here and they could kind of jump in with us. I know it's the weekend, but you know, if our bosses are in it to win it and you guys want this information, definitely get them in here so they can learn as well, okay? And so even on the replay, if you want to tag, Sorry, guys. Somebody is calling me. All right. So the next thing we're going to do is we are going to, with parties. Okay. Let me backtrack a little bit. With parties, did you guys know that you can host virtual parties in your back office? Like, this is the coolest feature that is probably the most underutilized feature in Paparazzi that we have. But basically, you can host parties through your back office. And how it works is you'll have a hostess, and they will invite their friends into the party. And basically, they will send out your website link for them to order pieces of jewelry on your website. And guess what, guys? You're going to get all of the PV associated to that party. So again, if you're hosting a website party, let's say I'm your hostess and I bring 10 friends and I say, okay, we're going to send out this, you know, you send me the link and then I send it to my family and friends, and everything that they buy, it's going to be PV for my website, and then that hostess is going to get hostess rewards, okay? There are tons of YouTube videos online that kind of explain how the hostess party works in the back office. Check it out. Now, I will honestly say that it's a little bit complicated. It's not as easy and straightforward to just go set it up. So it's going to take you a little bit of patience, but I promise you it's going to be worth it because, again, you don't have to have that inventory to be able to sell. Get your 45% commission. And Paparazzi is going to send it, of course, straight to every particular customer. Plus, they're going to keep track of like those hostess rewards. So my suggestion with something like that is to set up a Facebook group, a mess, like a set up like a event page online for that particular party. And that way you could kind of keep track of the audience that's coming, keep them engaged, maybe play some games in there. Maybe you could post some pictures of what's on the website just so they kind of have an idea. You can like give them opportunities to win prizes. So again, get creative, but you can use Facebook to your advantage with those parties. Okay. So that's just another way that I think you can consider looking into to get more of that PV to reach your goals. Okay. Another thing we're going to talk about is, and again, if you're writing notes, jot this down, because again, I'm giving you guys tons of information and resources of things that you can do and ideas that you can implement in your business. Okay. So the next one is going to be using your Facebook stories, guys. Okay. So a great thing that you could do is on Facebook, and this is even on Instagram or other social platforms, post your jewelry in your stories. You would be surprised at how many people don't really scroll their wall as much, but they love looking at stories. So you can post jewelry in your stories. You can also post some, let's say, blurbs on, if you want to know more about this business and want to join my, you know, join this business with me and get a discount on the jewelry, inbox me and I could tell you how. Or you could do a poll in there and say this or that. Do you like this earring or that earring? Both available on my website. You know, just anything that you could think of to kind of get people engaged, but have fun in your stories. And again, people will kind of check it out. They may, you know, do the polls. They may comment on what's going on. But again, that's another great way for you to get your jewelry out, and you can advertise your VIP group there if you have a business page. But again, don't forget to use your stories, because people do watch those stories, and you may be surprised at the engagement that you get, and that will also boost your algorithm. So as you kind of get people going to your stories and commenting and doing the polls and, you know, all of that, that's telling Facebook like, hey, this person is really working their business. They're, you know, they really are, you know, engaging with people. Let me make sure that when they go live, we send this feed to this person or that person. You know, you can do a giveaway on there and say, hey, whoever goes to my website and posts their favorite picture on their page and tags me, you know, I will give you 5 free pieces of jewelry or whatever it is. But again, use your stories to your advantage, because again, people watch those and you can get great business there, okay? The next thing we're going to talk about are using your VIP group to your advantage as well. So if you don't have a VIP group, I suggest you get one as soon as possible. Starting your VIP group is going to be so easy. It only takes maybe 5 minutes to get started, but you go to groups and you just do add, and you make your group whatever you want it to be, okay? You're going to add in your family and friends, your customers, what have you, and in there, you're going to be able to do certain things to sell your jewelry on an everyday basis, okay? The more consistent that you are doing any particular thing, the more you'll see results, okay? So I want to encourage everybody to, remember we talked about this graph here. You can use each of these boxes for something that you do in your VIP group or on your social media. So let's say this box, you may fill it in with your stories. So again, we're going to get into the VIP group. This one may be wall drops. I personally love wall drops, guys. My business is build on wall drop Wednesday. That's like my favorite thing in my VIP group. My customers love it. They know how to find me. Wall drop Wednesday all day long. I'm just posting jewelry all day and people love it. Even today in my VIP group, I'm doing like a flash Saturday wall drops where all day I'm just plugging in jewelry. So again, that's just a great way with those stock pictures or pictures that you've taken that are nice, just put them right in your VIP group and post those pictures. Because again, that's a great way for you to boost your sales outside of live, okay? With your wall drops, you can do flash sales in there. Flash sales are just quick ways, bite-sized ways to sell jewelry. That's where you're maybe laying your jewelry out on a nice table or, you know, a wood floor, what have you. And you're just showing the jewelry really quickly. Hey guys, this one is number one, da da da. This one's number two, number three, you know, that kind of thing. Now, again, there are tons of videos online on how to go about these more efficiently and to kind of explain how it works. But I'm just kind of giving you guys an overview of flash sales being really great to implement in your business. Another thing that you can do are album sales, okay? Album sales are pretty much where you are putting together an album in your group. So you'll go to albums and you'll go to new and you'll add in pictures of jewelry in that particular category. So let's say an album might be for all necklaces, all rings, all gold jewelry. You can do sets, you can do fashion fix sets, you can do blockbuster pieces. And that way people who want to shop for that particular thing know how to find that jewelry in a concise way. Okay, so again, this is all through our VIP groups. The next thing that we're going to talk about is considering using a messenger group. So some of you all may know we have something called Facebook Messenger where we can send messages to people. And this is a way for you to put together a group of maybe your exclusive VIP top customers. And you give them first dibs on maybe, let's say, your pre-sale. So when you go to order your new releases, you can kind of just load those into your messenger group and let them order there. In your messenger group, you may also post, you know, jewelry and themes. You may say, hey, Monday is going to be all about bracelets. So every Monday in your messenger group, you're posting jewelry and then they could kind of comment under the pieces that they want, or they could put a heart next to everything that they want added to their bag or what have you. However you want to do it, these are just supplemental ways that you can work your business and sell big, okay? The next thing I want you guys to consider is starting a Shopify or an online store. It doesn't cost that much to get them started, but basically what you need is some kind of site that you can put your inventory up on that site to sell big, okay? So again, you selling in that particular way is going to be great for your business because you're going to be able to not only sell on your lives and your flash sales and what have you, that inventory that you have kind of sitting at your house right now can be up on a website. And when people want to kind of shop by color, by type, what have you, they can shop right there on your website and you will get an alert. And then you can fill those orders and have those orders going straight out the door. Hello, good morning to everybody who's jumping in. Hello, guys. So again, consider a Shopify or some kind of online store where you'll be able to make those sales outside of Facebook, okay? Another thing to consider is getting the information from your customers outside of Facebook too. So let's say for whatever reason, Facebook today, and this would be like a meltdown for like probably every consultant in paparazzi, but what would happen if Facebook today said, we're no longer letting anybody go live. We're shutting it down. We don't want to use it anymore. That's it. What would you do? You know, you got to try to think about a contingency plan of sorts to say, hey, if this ever go, because I mean, think about it, the same way Facebook Live was never here before, it may one day just disappear. I mean, Facebook is always changing their policies, their guidelines. They change the way they like to do things with their business. It was recently that they changed, it was something that like the rooms, some kind of thing with the rooms they changed recently. They change things all the time, guys. So again, you don't want to be so heavily reliant on Facebook Live that you don't have other ways that you can sell your jewelry. So having a Shopify store, maybe figuring out some ways that you can host parties on Zoom. You know, these are some things that if you start implementing it, or even like with your VIP groups, if you start learning how to post in there, you'll have a strong other way, you know, outside of just live, that you're making money consistently in your business, okay? The next thing that we can do off of Facebook is also having a bling bag, guys. Bling bags are awesome. Bling bags, you can get them in the back office. You can go on Amazon and get them. Basically, you are just going to fill up a nice big bag with jewelry and you're going to take it around with you everywhere you go. If you're going to the grocery store, to the mall, if you are going to work, wherever you're going, you just take your bag with you. And if the opportunity presents itself for someone to want to shop, they can shop in your bag. Also, for those that you trust, you can do something called a bag party. Bag parties are basically you putting together a bag of bling. You have a friend or a family member that you trust that you know, like, if something goes wrong with this bag, this is what's in it. You know, you're going to be responsible for it or what have you. But somebody may just love the jewelry. They may say, you know what? I have coworkers that would, you know, go crazy over this jewelry. I'll take some of the jewelry to my office. I'll sell the jewelry. And you kind of set up something with them. And you say, for every 10 pieces you sell out of this bag, you can get one for free. Oh my gosh, free jewelry. Let's do it. You know? So again, that'd be something cool for that person to get free jewelry. They can sell tons out of that bag and you're going to make the profit, okay? So again, there are videos online on how to set up your bling bag, how to, you know, go about it. But again, I'm just kind of telling you guys like little tips of things that you can do to sell this jewelry, okay? Again, our goal is to move and to sell this jewelry big, because the more jewelry we can sell, the more money that we can make in this business, okay? And I know everybody came here in this business to make some big money, okay? So again, bling bags are the way to go. In the front of the bling bag, in the pockets that are kind of aligning the front, you could put cute jewelry, you could put your business card, you can kind of put a little blurb in the middle that says, if you love jewelry, ask me what's in my bag. You know, just something cute that kind of gets people talking if you're in the line at the grocery store, that kind of thing, okay? All right, next, we're going to talk about vending events, okay? The spring is here, summer's coming up. If you are open to it, you know, I know with COVID and pandemic and all of that, but if you are someone who is open to going out and getting some of these events, don't be afraid to look in your local newspaper, look online at local events and see what options are available for vending. Because of the pandemic, a lot of these vending fees are a lot less than they used to be. So this is a great way, if you're free on a Saturday, to just go to a local festival and just kind of sit out there with your jewelry, take a papa sister with you or something to kind of help you with the table, or a friend or a family member. And they can just kind of sit with you while you sell your jewelry. They can answer questions. Again, this is a way for you to get out there, to connect with new customers, potential recruits for your business. But again, a way for you to sell your jewelry, okay? Set up your table really cute. Maybe put up a little sign that kind of explains, you know, everything is just $5. Come stop by, what have you. Set up your starlit shimmer out there. Whatever it is that you want to do, but for your business, set up something where people could kind of come by, check out what you have, and you can sell big and get something out of it. Maybe you could try to get parties, customers, you know, as I mentioned, potential business partners out of it. Whatever you decide to do, make sure that you love it and you are, you know, excited about it, because people can always feel our energy when we do anything that we do, okay? So when you are at these events, come dressed up and look cute in your paparazzi wear or your pink or your whatever, gray, white, black, whatever. But again, wear your jewelry, look fabulous, and sell big, okay? Next, we're going to talk about personal shopping experiences, okay? I personally used to do this a lot when I first started in the business, where you get some customers and they might not want to go on live. They might not want to sit there for 2 hours, but they may say, hey, can I just FaceTime you after, or we set up a time together and I want to shop your boutique. Do you happen to have blue bracelets? I love blue. Do you happen to have yellow earrings? I'm going to an event next week and I need yellow earrings. This is your time with that customer to specifically give them what they are looking for, okay? Sometimes people are more inclined to shop with you directly and spend money with you when they can look for exactly what they are looking for. So if you're going live or you're posting in your VIP group, your Shopify, your wall drops, I mean, you know, your stories, that's what you are sharing with your customers. That is what you want to show and share. But sometimes your customers say, hey, she doesn't show enough blingy rings. I really love blingy rings. Or, you know, I wonder why I'd never get to see gunmetal hoops. I really would love to have that. You know, I'm looking for gunmetal hoops because I want to give all of my friends gunmetal hoops for Mother's Day. Whatever it is, if you set up personal shopping experiences with your customers, or at least let them know that that's something that you do offer, this is a way for you to make those extra money, but on a one-on-one basis. You can kind of customize it to them, make them feel amazing, like royalty, you know, because for your regular customers, for your, you know, your customers that kind of come, you know, you want to make them feel great. But for those customers that are consistent, they're loyal, they buy big, they're always there, they're always showing up for you, they're your biggest fan. Again, you want to treat them like royalty. You want to treat them like they are golden, okay? So if you can get some of them on some of the these shopping experiences, make it amazing for them. Tell them you can make it like a sip and shop. We're going to have our tea this morning and we're going to shop together. You can ask me questions. Girl, let me help you accessorize that. You know, show me the outfit that you're going to get for your party. We can hook it up and I can find a whole four-piece set for you. You know, okay, girl, if you get any 10, if you could get, if you decide to get 10 or more pieces today, I'm going to make you my hostess of the day. And I'll give you one free piece for every 10 pieces that you get. You know, that's going to make her feel like, wow, you know, Mel really cares. Mel is really taking the time to make sure that I look fabulous for whatever I have going on. And again, the more they feel like that, the more inclined they are to want to stay with you, the more inclined they are to want to shop with you and to keep coming back. Okay. So again, keep in mind ways that you can always incentivize. And again, we have tons of jewelry. We have tons of hostess rewards. This is your time to be able to give your customer something so they keep coming back. Because let's face it, everybody loves a free gift. Even if they don't necessarily like the particular piece that you gave them, they can still gift it to somebody else. They can still, you know, like maybe hold on to it for an outfit that they may get down the line. So again, don't ever think that, oh, you know, like I just have all this jewelry sitting around the house and what. No, use it. Push it out there and, you know, let them have an opportunity to be able to, you know, get blessed or get, you know, perks of your shopping with you and getting some benefits out of it. Okay. So thank you, Victoria, for that question. There are some times where I do let my customers pick their pieces for free, and there's some times that I don't. And I'll explain that. That's a great question. Thank you. And thank you for the Miss Donaldson. Thank you so much for you know, your compliment about the enthusiasm in business tips. It's my honor to be here with you guys. So, okay. So Victoria, typically what I do is I give away free jewelry on every single live. So for sharing my video at the end of every live, I put everybody into a drawing that shared my video. Now I may set the bar and say we have to get at least 4 shares for the day or 10 shares or something like that. But whatever the bar is, at that point, I either may give them 1 free piece, I may give them 5, 10 free pieces, you know, something like that. If they get something, you know, on a show, I may say to them, tell me your favorite color or the type of style that you like in jewelry, and I'll send you pieces in that particular color or theme or style or what have you. So for instance, if someone says my favorite color is purple, I'll know to make sure to send them purple things, but I will choose what I give them for free. Now, on the flip side, if I'm doing a party and someone is, you know, we're setting up a party and I have a hostess, what I may do is prior to the party, I may take them around my bling room and I'll say, hey, pick out any 10 pieces that you like. You know, I may go through the bins. What do you like? Braces? Do you like earrings, rings? What do you like? Necklaces, wooden necklaces, whatever. And I will basically take them on up one-on-one, like a virtual FaceTime kind of thing. And I'll let them pick. I'll say, oh, you like this? Okay, what have you? But what I do, or what I've done in the past, is I have, you know, those pegboards that you can get from like Burlington or Ross or TJ Maxx or something. It's like a board and it has like a clothespin with like the clips on it. What I tend to do for parties is I will have myself here at the party, and then behind me I will have the clothespin with the hostess gifts on, hanging on it. So what happens is I'm at the party. Hey guys, we're at Angie's party. Give it up for Angie. She's the hostess of the day. Behind me are all the pieces that Angie is working for tonight, okay? For every 10 pieces that you guys get, Angie's going to get to get one of these pieces behind me for free. So I kind of make it like a thing. So, all right, we sold 10 pieces, guys. Y'all know what that means. Angie's going to get her pick of, you know, a piece of jewelry. So she's already pre-picked these pieces, guys. So I'll say, all right, we 10 pieces in. Let's add one to Angie's bag. Congrats, Angie. Y'all give her some love. Woo! Make it a thing, you know. And then Angie gets that piece. And so what happens is people are wanting Angie to win the pieces on her board. You know, they're there for her, you know. So they're like, okay, let me just make sure that Angie gets these pieces. Sometimes, let's say you fall short of selling all the pieces on the board. Sometimes you'll see people say, hey, you know what? We didn't get to clear the board, but I want to buy Angie those last 3 pieces that we have left, you know. And so then Angie gets to go home with all 10 of her pieces that she wanted for her party. But again, That means that that hostess is now happy with all the pieces that she purchased. And then the customers who are there, they're going to say like, wow, like Angie got to get all those pieces that she wanted for free. You know, maybe I should consider hosting a party too, because I want to win some free jewelry as well. So again, they'll take it seriously too, to get people on there that are going to buy jewelry, that are going to participate, you know, that kind of thing. So it's just a way for you to make sure that your hostess is happy, because they are taking the time to invite their friends and family there with you. You guys can play games. Another way you can do it is you can give your guests a chance to win something that they want for free. So you can say, if you decide to host a party with me, you know, by midnight, you have to inbox me. I will let you choose any piece that I showed tonight, or you could choose any piece from my VIP group that's still available, or you can go on my website and you could choose, you know, any. And then upon booking your party, you know, I mean, upon us completing your party, I will give you that piece for free. You know, you can do one piece, 10 pieces, 5 pieces, whatever you choose. But oh, you're welcome, Denise, no problem. But again, that is just a way for you to make sure everybody's happy and they can get free pieces. You can also do mystery bags, guys. So you could put together bags and put 10 free pieces in it, and it could be your hostess rewards. And you could say, hey, I'm going to give this piece, I'm going to give everything that's in this bag to a guest who does blank. So let's say for everybody that joins my VIP group by midnight, I'm going to put you guys into a raffle to win 10 of these mystery pieces, and they'll be sent to you in the mail. I'll do a random drawing. Just whatever you could think of for these parties to get people to come back, to get them connected, to get them looking at your website. You want to make sure that when someone, and when you're hosting a party or you're doing anything where a hostess is involved and they have their friends and family, you want to try to capture as many of those people as possible. So always go into any event that you do as, how do I get these people to come back to me? So for instance, I recently did a bridal expo, and I put a box. I think they have the box in the back office where you can kind of fill out your information, name, address, phone number. Are you interested in hosting a party? Yada, yada. So I put that box, you know, at the front of my table. But next to the box, I put a Z Collection necklace. And I said, fill out your information on this card, and I will do a drawing for someone to win this piece of jewelry for free. Of course, it's a bridal expo. I picked something that was bridally, you know, blingy or pearls or something like that. I can't remember, but I put a Z Collection piece next to it. So that's going to draw attention, because people are like, wait, I want to win that necklace. So I get their information. I could connect with them on Facebook, you know, and I'll ask them like, do you want more information about hosting a party? Do you want to make some more money? Because two, they may say, I need some money to help pay for my wedding. Okay, sure, girl, let me tell you how. You know, so again, in your mind, you have to think, this is an event, these are brand new people, I need them to come back, okay? So that's just a tip, I hope that helps somebody. All right, so we talked about hostess rewards. Let's talk about, we talked about giving them away. Let's talk about selling these hostess rewards, okay, guys? Hostess rewards, I want you guys, every time you see a hostess reward, to think about it being free money, okay? What the heck is free money? I mean, is it a such thing as free money with hostess rewards? Yes, okay? So when you see those hostess rewards come in, don't just toss them in a corner somewhere. Take the time to go through them. Take the time to see what you could pair together as sets. Take the time to figure out, like, if you have multiples of pieces that you've gotten over time that you can now sell on your show. Because let's say over the course of 6 months, you've gotten 5 of a particular necklace. Now you could take those 5 pieces and sell them on your page. So again, look at your hostess rewards as dollar bills and not just like jewelry that you're kind of tossing. 100% profit on everything that you sell. That's a hostess reward. Now you guys know with the jewelry that we buy, we are getting a percentage of that money. We're getting $2.25 off of every piece. So again, that's awesome. We're getting our commission off of each piece we sell. But you want to make sure that those hostess rewards are not just kind of brushed off, because that is literally $5 each and every time, okay? So again, as you're trying to work towards your selling goals and trying to work towards your life at a party, the more money that you have to put towards buying new inventory, the better. So maybe you can say, my goal for the month of May, because I'm trying to hit life at a party gold or whatever. Oh my gosh, I really want to hit gold. I know I'm going to get double hostess rewards. I got to hit my goal. What I'm going to do is I'm going to try to sell 100 of my hostess rewards. I mean, the goal is yours. But again, you can say, I'm going to use that as pure profit to make sure I can reinvest that back into my business so that I can hit my goals. So you don't want to fall short in this season because, again, we only have 2 months left to make this happen. So this is your time to hustle and figure out, like, what can I do and what resources do I have available to make this happen, okay? So I believe in all of you guys, and I know you guys can do it and kill it and crush your goals. Really quickly, let me make sure I didn't miss anything on my notes. Oh, when selling, you want to make sure that you're utilizing your VIP page. If you have a business page, you may want to consider using your business page. And again, really easy to set up pages. Just go to the pages option in Facebook and just set up your own business page. So you can sell there. That's where I personally go live. You guys can check me out. It's called the Love Sparkle Glow Boutique. That is my boutique, but you guys can kind of check me out, hang out with me. I play games and I, you know, you can kind of get an idea there of like how I run my parties and my games during my lives and stuff. But I have a business page. I think everybody should have a business page. You can kind of boost some of your posts and things like that, which is awesome. And then also your main profile. I want everybody today, if you have some time, to go to your main page and you tell yourself, a friend, family member, whatever, what do you get from your main page? Do you get that you're a businesswoman or a guy? Do you get that you are serious about, you know, paparazzi? Are you wearing paparazzi in your profile picture? Do you post the jewelry every so often? Do people know that you sell jewelry? Do people know that you love your business? Now, I'm not saying that your page should just be only about paparazzi, because maybe from your page, I may be able to say, oh, this person loves her dogs, or she is she likes to knit sweaters, or whatever it is that you love to do. She likes to cook chili or whatever, you know, like whatever your thing is, that's what people are going to draw to as well. But I also should be able to go there to tell that you are about your business, you know? So if you are somebody who is running for a life of their party goal or trying to sell, I think the most consistent and efficient way to sell your jewelry is to make sure that you are believing in your brand, that people believe that you believe it. If I want to go to buy tacos, right? And I go into a restaurant and I don't see tacos on the menu, I'm not going to know that I can get tacos there. I'm going to think I might have to go somewhere else, because if I see burgers and french fries and hamburgers, I mean, I said that already, and hot dogs or something, you know, I'm going to think like, oh, they don't have tacos here. But maybe they could say, oh yeah, we have tons of tacos in the back. You know, we have, you know, every taco you can imagine. But if I'm in the restaurant and I don't see it advertised, I'm going to think like, oh, they don't offer that. So the same for you. If you're trying to hit a goal, if you're trying to sell big, the biggest way to do that is to be about your brand, okay? You have to fall in love with paparazzi with all your heart before you can get anybody else to fall in love with it, okay? So again, you should always be wearing your jewelry. You never want to be in a position where somebody is like, oh my gosh, I love those earrings. Are those paparazzi? And you're like, oh no, it's not, you know? So like, I'm not saying you can't ever mix it up, but you don't want to be in a position where you're always out or on your lives or what have you wearing stuff that's not paparazzi. Now, this is the one thing that I wear that's not paparazzi, but this is a bracelet that my husband bought me. It's like sentimental to me. So this is the only one thing that I have that's not paparazzi. But for you, you may have earrings that your grandmother left you, or a necklace that is sentimental in some kind of way. I'm not saying that you can't wear anything that's not paparazzi, but what I am saying is you should be about your brand. People should be able to look at you, see how you move, watch your pictures, your videos, your lives, and know, oh, she's about paparazzi and she loves this jewelry business. Because I know you guys do, and I know you guys want to hit every single goal that you set for yourselves in this business, and I can't wait to see you all do it, okay? So that is it for me. I hope that this helped somebody today. I hope that you guys are all geared up and ready now to conquer the world and to make big sales before this paparazzi year is over. And again, as soon as July 1st comes, you have a new goal in your mind that you should be setting for yourself for the next year, okay? So even right now, I want you guys to look at the perks at each level of life of the party and tell yourself like, okay, by the end of this year, I'm going to hustle to do this, but come July 1st, I plan on doing that, okay? So start looking at it, start implementing these tips, because honestly, these are some suggestions that you can start implementing, but probably by July and August is when they're really going to start taking off, because again, anything that you do consistently will start to work over time. So maybe if you start posting in your stories today or tomorrow, it may not work right away. You know, you can't just do it once or twice and think like, oh, it's a bust, it doesn't work. No, what you're going to do is say, okay, I'm going to start posting. Okay, give you a perfect example. If you guys know about Mandy, her name online is Sugar Bee Bling. She's really awesome at flash sales. So what she does is every morning, I think it's at 8 o'clock, she does flash sales. Every night, I believe it's like at 9 o'clock, she does flash sales. Every day, I believe. I don't know the schedule like the top of my head, but it's like every single day she goes live. So people know if it's 8 o'clock and it's before I'm going to work, I'm going to catch Mandy for my flash sale. And I have seen her sell like 100 pieces in 15 minutes or something. It's remarkable. So for those people who are like, I don't have the time to sit through a 2-hour live, I just have 5 minutes, 10 minutes to kind of catch what I want and go, boom, you have those flash sales. But again, she's consistent with a schedule on those days. For me, I mentioned I do Wall Drop Wednesday. On Wall Drop Wednesday, my customers know all day long in my VIP, they are getting jewelry, 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 jewelry. Now, I love that because I can auto post them and I could kind of have them going. I could set it up and just have it like posting all day long and I'm just like doing other things. But again, make your business work for you. But the more you show up consistently and do the right things for your business, you're going to see it start to pay off, okay? So that's it for me, guys. Have a great, amazing, and wonderful weekend. And again, I can't wait to see you guys crush all your goals, okay? Have a great day. And again, thank you, Danielle, for having me on with the rock stars, the elite rock stars here today. I'll talk to you guys later. Bye.